Hello, everyone. I'm Hyung Seok from U.S.A University College of Medicine. I'm working at a Severance hospital, and it's really honored to be here as an interview to talk with Professor Dr. JesseC.Selber. He is a well-known plastic surgeon for his achievement of robotic breast reconstruction. He developed and reported the world's first robotic LD reconstruction. And he also, in 2012, and also he developed the robotic intraperitoneal approach for the DIEP harvest. So hello, Dr. Selber, how are you?
Good, how are you? Nice to see you again.
Good to see you. Okay, so please introduce yourself to GBCC TV viewers.
Sure, my name is JesseC. Selber. I'm the vice chair of the Department of Plastic Surgery and director of clinical research at MD Anderson Cancer Center in Houston, Texas. Nice to see you all.
Okay, nice to see you. Okay, thank you. So let's move on. Let's talk about the robotic reconstruction surgery. So you are a pioneer of the robotic breast reconstruction. Your first attempt to robotic reconstruction inspired many surgeons all over the world. Back to your first robotic reconstruction case, would you like to explain why you began a breast reconstruction using a robotic system?
Sure. So the first procedure that I developed for robotic breast reconstruction was the lupus dorsi, as you mentioned, in 2012. And that came about because I noticed that the principal reason why people didn't like the lupus dorsi procedure was the scar on the back. It tends to be rather painful and it tends to widen. It also interferes with shoulder function. And so I thought that if a woman could go without that scar, that she would benefit. And so that started me to experiment in the laboratory with this procedure. And after I was sufficiently convinced it was safe, I brought it to the operating room.
Okay. So was there any difficult issue to perform robotic breast reconstruction for the first time, especially in your institution? Support you were... first attempt?
Yeah, the first attempt took a long time. There was a lot of logistic issues in the operating room. And anytime you do something for the first time, there's no guidebook. So you have to kind of build the plane while you fly it, as they say. And the other thing is there are some regulatory issues. And so I'm lucky enough to be at a hospital which values innovation very much. And so they were encouraging my innovative approach, but there are a lot of places where regulations would prevent you from doing such things.
Yeah, that's right. I also experienced the regulation issue of the robotic mastectomy. Yeah, it's really harder to overcome that kind of issues. So, okay. So the next question is, what do you think of the advantages and the disadvantages of the robotic breast reconstruction or robotic breast surgery?
Well, the advantages for both the LD, and we haven't talked about the robotic DIEP approach, but we can talk about that shortly. But both are basically to limit the event and morbidity associated with surgical incisions. So for the LD, I do all of the approach through the mastectomy incision. And so there's no incision on the back at all. Of course, this is requires a situation where you don't need a skin either. But the advantage is you eliminate an incision, which is probably about 15 to 18 centimeters long. For the robotic DIEP approach, you're eliminating an incision, which is essentially like a laparotomy incision, and you're turning it into an incision, which is just around the perforator itself. And so this would be the same benefit that you would get from, a minimally invasive approach to intra-abdominal surgery versus a laparotomy. Quite a bit of benefit in pain and reduction in hernia and bulge. The disadvantages, of course, logistics, regulatory environment, as we discussed, impossible. Those are the main obstacles that we have to overcome.
Okay, so you told me that the less painful procedure and then the less scar are the main advantage of the robotic mastectomy. So what do you think of the cost effectiveness of the robotic surgery? So is this disadvantage? So do you think that there is a cost effective issue in the States?
Yes. So for robotic mastectomy, it's hard to say. When you talk about cost, you always have to talk about cost to who? Who is incurring the cost? So, you know, the cost of the robot is a capital investment that's made by a hospital. So that cost does not really affect any individual procedure that's done. The charge, I don't know exactly how it works in Korea, but the professional service fee that the physician charges is identical. So for the physician, it's cost neutral. Insurance covers robotic procedures in America. And so the patient does not see extra money, does not see extra cost. The insurance company does see extra cost. Then another component that may be somewhat unrecognized is the hospital receives extra revenue from a robotic operator because they're able to charge more because it's a more complex environment. So the contribution margin, which is the revenue minus expense for the hospital, is actually higher for a robotic procedure. So the hospital makes money, the surgeon is neutral, the patient is neutral, and the insurance company.
Okay, that's good. Okay, you already performed the robotic LD and the DIEP reconstruction and published the result in the literature. So in your usual clinical practice, which reconstruction method is your preferred method? So, and what do you think of the proper indications of robotic?
Yeah, it's an important question. So, you know, the DIEP has evolved because of the invasiveness of the full muscle tram and the muscle sparing tram, which causes, you know, increased hernia and bulge. So the DIEP was developed, you know, to avoid those problems. And it really has been relatively unchanged for about the last 20 or so years. And although we've been able to limit the number of perforators to a small number, we still have to make a long fascial incision to get to the pedicle. And so by doing a robotic intraperitoneal approach, we completely eliminate that long fascial incision and limit it to just a very small incision. However, the vascular anatomy has to be appropriate. And the appropriate vascular anatomy is one or two perforators that are grouped closely together, very short intramuscular force. And I can determine that in advance by the CAT scan. And I can know who's appropriate for a robotic DIEP. And it turns out it's about 30% of patients that I scan preoperatively are appropriate for that operation.
So for beginners or the trainees who are likely to learn robotic breast surgery, so which one is the most important thing to learn? So breast anatomy or some robotic control, robotic handling, or et cetera?
I think there's a lot of components to that. The specific procedures involve very different skills. So doing the mastectomy dissection under insufflation, you know, requires the ability to dissect the plane and to continue to manage your space appropriately. The intraperitoneal dissection for a DIEP is a vascular dissection, it's a completely different approach, and it's done much like laparoscopic surgery. So that's really a different set of skills. The common denominator is understanding how the console controls the device at the patient's bedside. So developing that set of skills is really important. But it's also really important to understand how the machine that actually interfaces with the patient works. It's very tricky, actually, to get the nuances. And so you really need to understand not just how to drive the car, but how to kind of fix the car if it's not working quite right, or, you know, to move things around to optimize it. And I think that requires some time with the device.
So do you train your residents or some fellows so for the robotic breast reconstruction?
Yes, I try to train the fellows as they come through. So of course, we have the full year.
In my experience, my fellows are really eager to learn about the robotic mastectomy. So because they are young and they wanted to learn the new technique, I think that the States is almost similar with that kind of the behavior. So I think that you are a pioneer of the robotic breast reconstruction. I think that you can share your experience with your young surgeons. So I think that I performed the robotic mastectomy before doing the real robotic mastectomy for real human. So I performed the cadaveric surgery. So I also do the animal lab for the robotic surgery. So do you think that is it necessary, or do you think that is it useful or the essential for the learning robotic surgery for a beginner?
I do. I mean, all of the procedures that I developed, I spent time in the lab developing them. And some of them were quite quick. The robotic deep evolved very quickly because I was already doing robotic rectus muscle harvests. But the robotic LD took me over a year in the lab to really perfect so that I was comfortable before I could be operating. And I think for breast surgeons, you know, if they don't have robotic experience, they really need to work on some cadavers or be, you know, in an environment where they can get graduated responsibility and do little steps at a time with somebody who really knows how to do the operation. I don't think it's safe to just do it, you know, for the first time without having experience on the robot.
Yeah, that's right. So nowadays, my colleague in plastic surgery, he developed the extraperitoneal approach for the harvest.
Yes, sir.
If we meet again in the next GBCC or something else, somewhere else, so we can share our experience with you. I hope that's so.
Yeah, so, there are a couple of people doing that here in the United
States. Yeah. Oh, really? Oh, yes. That's good. Mm-hmm. I think the techniques are so developing. So do you have any other comments for the viewers of the GBCC TV?
Well, I would first like to thank the illustrious Dr. Park for inviting me. He's very well known and a pioneer in this field. So congratulations and thank you for that. And also just want to say that, you know, I do firmly believe that these procedures have advantages for patients. And if I didn't think that they benefited the patient, then I wouldn't do it. And I think robotics will be the future of many, many surgeries that we do now open. And I think that will evolve with evolving technology and experience. Thank you for your time.
Thank you. Thank you. I'd like to thank your achievement in robotic breast surgery and sharing your experience on it. I'm looking forward to meeting you again and hope you and your family being healthy and good.
And you as well.
Yeah, okay. Thank you. Goodbye. Thank you. Bye.